Hi everybody, Tower 7. In case you didn't know, we are going to have Tower 7 nurses be the catheter insertion experts for the hospital. So you're going to be part of the catheter insertion team or difficult catheter insertion team, and very good outcomes with hospitals that have these teams. And so I'm putting together this video to show you kind of what I've put together as your educator to support you in this. And if you have any suggestions, please reach out to me. I'm open to all suggestions of things that you would like to see on the difficult catheter insertion cart that I made for you, or other tips or research, any research that you want me to do, I'm happy to do that. But I want to go through a couple of things that I put together already. So there's a big blue difficult catheter insertion cart that I put together. It lives in the physician's workroom right now. There is a key to this cart. We're going to keep it locked, and the key is going to be kept next to the charge nurse desk in the drawer. It is clearly labeled Tower 7 difficult catheter insertion cart. You're going to grab that key, take that cart wherever you need to go for difficult catheter insertion. Now, I wanted to go through some tips and tricks that I've found over the years of putting in many catheters back in my years of ER nursing, and then also tips I found on the internet and just things from research that I found that I want to share with you. But I want to go through that cart just a little bit more. I want to talk about what you're going to find in that cart. There is a list that I've made of all the things that should be in the cart. And then when you're done with any difficult insertion, you can send this to the storeroom and they can send you back any supplies that you might need. But in this top drawer is going to be extra lubricant, extra iodine, a razor if you need it. There's a 60 cc, 30 cc, and 10 cc Lure Lock syringe. There's also two of those 2 ounce catheter tip with the big graduated tip catheters, syringes. And then as you go down a drawer, you're gonna find a 14 French Coudé catheter kit. There's gonna be 2 of those in there. And then in the next drawer is a 16 French Coudé catheter kit, 2 of those. And then in that drawer as well, there's 1 just regular 16 French catheter kit in case you need it. As you go down in the drawer to the bottom drawer, we're going to include everything you need for continuous bladder irrigation. I'm just putting it in there in case somebody calls and needs help with something like that. So included in that is going to be a catheter drainage bag. There's 2 of those in there. A 22 French triple lumen three-way catheter for continuous bladder irrigation. And then the Y tubing that you need for continuous bladder irrigation. And then the 3000 milliliter bags of normal saline for the irrigation. There's 2 of those. And then a couple of leg bags and a couple of plugs for that triple lumen catheter in case you need to discontinue the irrigation, but don't want to take that catheter out. So that's what's in the cart. I'm working on finding you a headlamp that you can wear so that when you're doing the difficult insertion, somebody doesn't have to hold the flashlight for you. Trying to find something with a plastic strap that we can easily clean. Otherwise, it might just be a handheld flashlight if I can't find anything. So if anybody has any ideas, I'm open to those ideas. But the other thing I want to talk about before putting in a catheter is lidocaine jelly. It's the key to good catheter insertion. So in case you don't know, we use a brand called Glido. Here it is. It's a Glido lidocaine jelly insertion syringe, and you have to call the doctor to get this ordered, but it is going to be the key to difficult catheter insertion. It's gonna mean the difference between getting the catheter in and not getting it in sometimes. And it can be used on both male and female patients. I'm going to show you a different picture here, and it shows you that the tip of this Glido syringe is meant to insert into the urethral opening so that you can inject lidocaine jelly right into the urethral opening on a male and a female patient. So the tip of that Glido syringe is meant for insertion right in, and then you squirt that lidocaine right down into either the male or female urethra. And that is gonna numb up that whole area. It's gonna lubricate all the way into the urethral opening down almost to the bladder. Numb that area up. And sometimes the key to getting a catheter in is relaxation of the prostate and the urethra so that it's not spasming. And that lidocaine jelly is gonna make all the difference. So if you get a call that they need help getting in a catheter, first thing you're gonna do is tell them to call the doctor and get the GlidoJet. And then once you have the Glido injection, they need to inject that before you get there so that that lidocaine has time to work. Okay, enough about the lidocaine. Let's now talk about some other tips and tricks for inserting a catheter. So any man, they say over the age of 55, probably you should go straight to Coude. That's gonna be a professional judgment on your part. But I think that that's probably reasonable, and we have actual Coude kits. So let me grab an example. This is what you're going to find in the difficult catheter cart. Here is a 16 French Coude kit. So everything you need to put in a Coude catheter in this kit. And like I said, there's also a 14 French in the difficult catheter cart. So you're going to have access to both. You just push the cart to where you go, pull out what you need, and everything should be there. So when you open up this kit, it's just like your normal catheter kits, except that you're gonna have that stiff and curved Coude tip to work with, which is much better than the more flexible, bending, normal Foley catheter. So let me grab the kit here. Now you're gonna keep strict sterile field. As an educator working it on a mannequin, I may break that sterile field. Please do not do that. but I am not wearing gloves, and I just want to show you what the tip of the catheter looks like on the Coude. I'm going to stand back here, and I'm going to use my scrubs as the background, and you can see it's gently curved right here, and it's much stiffer on the end. That is to get past that prostate. We want that curve to go in and scoop up past the prostate. The other key is keeping the patient relaxed. So when I come in the room, I need to do really good teaching with my patient, explain the procedure and say, you know, this is gonna work a lot better if you take deep breaths and relax and try to go to a happy place while I'm putting this catheter in. I know it's not gonna be comfortable, but we've numbed up the urethra, so it should be more comfortable for you. And then as you're inserting the Coude, you want this curve to be toward the patient's head, and you want to scoop past that prostate as you're putting it in. So another tip I found, and I thought this was genius, I didn't know about this, was as you expose your patient, when you're leaning over, and I'm going to pull this down a little bit so that you can kind of see what I'm doing here. As you're leaning over, I'm going to put some gloves on. I just can't do this without gloves, even though it's a mannequin. Okay, so I did my WHO hand hygiene method. I'm putting on my sterile gloves, right? Because I'm putting in a catheter. I'm going to maintain sterile field. I'm going to have a second nurse here helping me to make sure I don't break my sterile field. And I'm going to hold the penis. As I'm holding the penis, if you kind of rest your arm on the patient's leg, as you're inserting the Coude, you can feel when the patient tenses up under your arm. And that's when you're gonna stop and wait for the patient to take a deep breath and relax. And when you feel the leg muscles relaxed, that's when you're gonna advance the Coude. And you're gonna, you know, use your lubricant, even though you put lidocaine on it. And so the patient's tensing up, I'm gonna pause a minute. Can you take a deep breath for me? Take a deep breath in through your nose, out through your mouth. I can feel the patient relaxing under my arm, and that's when I'm going to put it in, and it's going to slide past that prostate. So that's one of the things you can do, is don't advance that catheter until you feel the patient relax, because when the patient's not relaxed and everything's tight, that prostate's tight, and then you're not going to get the Coude past the prostate. The other thing you might find when you get to a difficult catheterization is the patient may have phimosis, meaning that the foreskin is up completely covering the end of the penis and you can't see the urethral opening. One of the things you can try is if you push on the suprapubic area of the patient, sometimes that will help retract that foreskin back a little bit so that then that urethral opening can kind of peek out at you and you can get that catheter in. Now you're gonna have a second nurse in the room helping you with this, so maybe they can be the one to push on that suprapubic fat area to get that foreskin to retract a little bit. The other thing you might find in male patients is what we call hidden penis or buried penis. If that's the case, then the other nurse in the room is gonna glove up and with both hands around the penis, push down, straight down on the edge of the penis. And sometimes that will push that penis out a little bit, just enough so that you can find that urethral opening and go ahead and get your catheter into that urethral opening. So all of these things are gonna take a second nurse. Now the primary nurse that called you for help should be in that room helping you anyway. So you should not need to bring a second Tower 7 nurse. That nurse that owns this patient or is primary for this patient should be the one to help with that procedure. Okay, so now let's talk about a female difficult catheterization. So sometimes it's just a matter of not being able, I'm gonna bring this back up. Sometimes it's just a matter of not being able to see the urethral opening, right? And if that's the case, then that flashlight that I'm hopefully gonna find is going to help, right? A headlamp or a second nurse to kind of hold that flashlight. And so that's one of the things you can do. Now, obviously, if you can't find the urethral opening, you can't squirt lidocaine jelly into it. But what you can do is you can squirt the lidocaine onto a piece of gauze and place it over the space where that meatus lives and just place that lidocaine jelly in that whole area so that you've at least numbed up the outside. And sometimes that can relax the patient enough so that you can get in there and really find that meatal opening. The other thing that might happen on postmenopausal women is that meatus somehow travels down. I know this is weird with this mannequin, but so here's the meatus and here's the vaginal opening. And sometimes now that meatus is down in the vaginal opening under and inside the vagina. It's always anterior. So what you can do is take that Coudé tip on your female patient, insert it into the vagina with your finger, and you can feel where that meatal opening is and push that Coudé up into the meatus and then push it in. Now, that's best case scenario, right? Sometimes you just end up in the vagina. If that's the case, leave your catheter in the vagina and then go anterior on top of that catheter that you put in that's in the vagina and try again. And sometimes you can slip it into the meatus. So those are some of the tips and tricks you can try. Always start with lidocaine, please, please, please. It's just a better way and a nicer way to take care of your patients. Always have that second nurse if you can. And so now let's talk about penis. So let's say your patient has a big penis. Let me grab the penis. We have a sling, here it is, meant for patients with big penis. And so if you lay this on top of the patient, I'm not gonna show you how to use the entire penis sling, but I am gonna include the directions in with the cart. So when I put this penis sling on, I'm gonna put a chucks over top of it. Here we go, I'm gonna pretend like this is the chucks. And I'm gonna put this around the patient's belly and then I can pull the patient's belly back by either tying it to the headboard or using the lift. And that will help lift the patient's penis up and out of the way. So please use all the tools that we have, and I'm putting this in your difficult insertion cart so that you won't have to go find a penis sling when you're out there doing it. But at least review how to hook the penis sling up and how to do this, maybe practice a little bit. One final thing, when you go to do a procedure on a patient, go with confidence. I mean, I know that sounds cheesy, but if you go in with this attitude, like I got this, you will have this. I mean, you will get it. Maybe not every time, but it'll get better and better over time. The more you do things, fake it till you make it. I don't know, but just have that attitude. Like, I can do this and it will get you far. I promise. So I know you're all laughing at me at this point, like, haha, but I do feel like that's true. Please reach out to Melissa Plate if you have any questions. And I'm so proud that Tower 7 is going to own this, because I think you guys are amazing nurses. And I'll see you soon.